One of the goals I set for this year here on the Process Driven YouTube channel is to start navigating the world of brand sponsorships. We've done it here or there, but not so intentionally. As we've started to get more and more into this world, I've started to realize how the processes we talk about so much on this channel can really support us and others as we're navigating this world of brand deals or brand sponsorships. Today, what I'm going to be doing is taking you inside our ClickUp account and showing you some of the basic setups we're using to manage the brand sponsorships and brand deals, whatever you want to call them, inside our ClickUp account. When it comes to sponsorships, we at ProcessDriven are trying to view it as a service. One of the projects we did to kick off the year was what we called sponsorships as a service. And it was literally just us treating the sponsorship experience as we would any other service offering. To get us started though, this wouldn't really be a ProcessDriven video if we didn't talk about the process that goes behind this template. So let's first go into Whimsical and I'll show you a little bit of what our flow is. Keeping it very simple, this is about what we ended up with. We started off our sponsorships experience by some kind of get in touch moment. Because we're mainly just reacting to proactive brands reaching out to us at this stage, the get in touch part of our process is pretty reactive. We're mainly just managing this inside our inbox by using some templates and fielding some questions. So I won't cover too much here. Moving on beyond get in touch, we get to the screening phase. And this is where some more systemization starts to come in. And I hope it'll be interesting to see. In the screening stage, this is where we start to log people's information in our sponsor or brand database, our CRM. So going inside our ClickUp account where we manage all of this, you can see the sponsors and brand CRM right here. And we have a task represent each particular brand that we are considering working with or who has reached out to us. So around this stage, we might add John Doe, for example, as a new contact, and then we are ready to start screening this person to evaluate whether or not this brand is not a good fit, maybe a prospect, maybe something else. The way our screening process works at ProcessDriven is kind of three sub-steps. So if we were to zoom into screening, we would see these three. The first thing we're screening for is audience fit. Basically, what we're evaluating here is, does your brand or offer or whatever actually add value to our audience if we introduce them to you? In this piece, we're also considering whether or not your brand or offer or service actually helps our audience with the mission that our company has, which is to help small teams systemize their operations. If a brand reached out with a very vague request, or from our context clues or research, we couldn't quite figure out this first step, but we wanted to give a particular potential sponsor a bit of a chance, we might reach out with an email like this to get more clarification. This is where some of the systemization does come in, because these are templated emails that we've created inside our missive account. And if you don't know what missive is, you'll find out more up here, in order to make sure that we're consistently communicating with sponsors and getting the information we need to know. Once we've wrapped up the audience fit piece, maybe we've confirmed that yes, they're good to go on that front, we're ready to evaluate the product. And this is more of a preliminary look, but what we're trying to see is this brand reputable? Is their product amazing? For ProcessDriven right now, because we're able to be so selective, we're pretty much only working with brands that we already use, we already love, that is part of our daily workflows here at ProcessDriven. So that makes it pretty easy. But in the cases where there's a tool that we maybe used to use or is adjacent to what we use and we're still considering it for the audience fit factor, this is where we're going to be doing some research. Once we get through this piece of evaluating the product, we're ready to move on to logistics. And logistics is kind of a catch-all stage of evaluating whether our basic kind of parameters for an engagement are being met. This is conversations like the loose budget, the timeline, and the values and ethics. Basically, what are you looking to get out of this relationship? At this stage, we might introduce another missive template, such as this one that we wrote up, to help make sure that we hit on all the main talking points. This email breaks down our common ways of working with folks, and this, that, and the other, and kind of starts that conversation into more serious details conversations. If we can check out the logistics stage and everything else looks good, we should have two pieces of information tracked inside our CRM. The first is in the area I already showed you. We have this kind of brands CRM where we're tracking information about the general company. And as we have started to vet them and check their reviews online and so on, we'll track that information here in this general John Doe Co. example. You can see we have kind of a default generic CRM layout here, tracking key people, descriptions, and so on, links to common files, and our kind of likeliness to work with them again. All of this is tracked here as kind of our overall relationship to a brand. And as we move folks through the journey of working with us or not, we'll track that here. However, The actual specifics of a particular brand deal are actually tracked separately in ClickUp for us, using a separate kind of opportunities tracking area. Ooh, and quick reminder, if you're enjoying this video so far, please do like and subscribe. It costs you nothing, but it helps this video show up to more people in the YouTube algorithm. Thank you, back to the video. So if, for example, we were having the logistics conversation and we're ready to move on to the next step, our wrap up here would actually involve creating one new task to represent the potential brand deal itself. Doing so would be on our brand's deals database, and it would look something like this. This one is a little bit further along than where we were previously, but in this area, the task here is representing the overall contract, not the company, but the particular contract that's being discussed. But at this point, we reach a crossroads in our process. We need to evaluate based on the answers we found out previously, whether or not it is worth moving forward with this sponsor. I would say 99% of the time, we end up going down the no path, and this is what happens here. First of all, we log the request. So we have a folder system inside Missive and a tracker in our CRM in order to track when there is a brand that we are just not interested in working with. So say John Doe Co., sorry, it's not a good fit. We track that here. Or maybe the company is a great fit, but the particular brand deal is not. We could also track that inside our account. The reason we like to track these is so that way, in case circumstances change, we can reach back out later. Or if the brand reaches out again, which has happened on a few occasions, you know, they raise a round of funding, their situation has changed, their budget has changed. We have this context, so we're not starting back at square one. After that happens though, we have the unfortunate task of declining the opportunity and letting the person know why it wasn't a fit or just that it was a timing breakdown. The beauty of having these kinds of templates, like the one I'm showing you on the screen here, is that these give us a starting off point for having a polite and professional conversation while giving us the space to customize them one by one when we actually send the email. These are all here using Missive templates, using their dynamic variables that swap out person's information, which makes it really convenient to make sure that these look polished and consistent every time. I would say the steps I've showed you right here, and even just the Missive templates, because we end up rejecting so many sponsorships, this has been a huge time saver for me. I used to be handling all of these kinds of requests myself, and I would just end up ignoring them, honestly, which isn't the best first impression. But getting this systemized, as you see here, has allowed me to delegate it. And if you are someone who's interested in delegating your inbox, we do have a video on that whole journey up at the top. But moving on, let's say we do have a fit. We are, you know, talking to a brand. It's like, yes, this is going to be awesome. Our audience will love this. This will be great for your brand's goals. Let's do it. When that happens, we move on to the scoping stage. Now, scoping could also be called the negotiation phase. It's whatever works for your brain. But for this particular phase, we are moving beyond just talking about the company in general. And let's just say John Doe is, you know, a prospect. And now we're focused more on the specific deal at hand. There are times where we've got amazing companies that we'd love to work with, but the logistics and so on just don't work out, so the deal falls through. And we're tracking these things separately for those reasons, so we can track the company relationship separately from the opportunity itself. Here, though, we have a potential sponsorship arrangement, a potential contract with John Doe. It's a featured video series, and we have it tracked here. In this imaginary example, we use a task description to track all of the details of the project. And in our process map, we know that the scoping process takes three different stages. First, budget, then deliverables, then details. The budget piece is the biggest one and the one I always start with, because if a brand is not clear about what their budget is for advertising or marketing, they're probably not at the level of professionalism that I would want our company to be working with. The interesting part about this budget piece is that you not only need to determine the costs and value of the services you're providing to the sponsor, but you also need to evaluate what kind of strategy you want to take when it comes to your sponsorship as a product. Just like any product, we have the opportunity to go high volume or low volume. And I think for us here at Process Driven, getting into this sponsorships thing this year, one of the priorities slash challenges I have set for our team is I don't want a lot of sponsors. I want a few long-term committed sponsors who are like partners in this journey and that our audience get to know and like and trust, and it becomes part of our audience's world for the long term. I'm not interested in our channel becoming a review channel where there's a new tool popping up every day. That just doesn't fit our vibe. And that has implications for this budget conversation. Brands that want to just pop on for one quick sponsored video or dedicated plug, it's just not going to work with our minimum engagement and the kind of experience we're trying to protect for our audience. So I'd encourage you to think about that here at the budget stage and make sure you're thinking not only a per engagement or per event or per video sponsorship budget, but also big picture, What kind of quantity, quality, and so on do you want to meet your sponsorship revenue goals? Moving on, we have details. And this is where we're talking about the finer points of a contract, like editorial control, number of revisions, any competitors that you need to maintain a distance from, and so on. And keep in mind, all of these little pieces I'm telling you about inside this workflow, these aren't things we're just memorizing. Each of these pieces would be reflected in templates we'd be applying to our task in ClickUp as the relevant step happened. So when we realized we had to scope it out, we'd apply a template that would have subtasks for all of the things we need to do. So we're just kind of adding it as we go, as we move down the process. So that's kind of all that happens in the scoping phase. This includes the contract, the deposit, all of that stuff is factored into this. And one little pro tip I will share about the scoping piece that has helped us a whole lot is making sure that each modular detail or change is something that is indeed modular in your contract or your invoicing system. If you optionally have two packages, make sure you have like a drop down in your contract where you can actually pick which package and you're not creating all of these things manually every time. It took us a little bit more time up front, but by creating a conditional contract where certain things like the scope of work would swap out based on what choice we made at the onset, the intake stage, having our contracts and other things be conditional like that allows us to have one version that we can use for just about everything and makes this scoping to delivery phase a pretty smooth transition. If anyone's curious how we do that, just let me know in the comments below. We can make a follow-up video, but I'll just say we use CognitoForms, really cool tool, in order to do those kinds of pieces. Moving on from scoping, we get into the delivery phase, and this is where we get into more traditional project management activities. So what this looks like is more of a traditional project management flow, and for us, that means applying yet another template where we load in the specific tasks and subtasks that we need in order to do a typical sponsorship. So we have templates that outline all of the steps that need to happen, who needs to do them, what's the due date, and so on. We also have a task in that project, as you see here, called Create Project Plan. Despite the fact that we are applying templates, we still want a human being who's coordinating this project to make sure all of the subtasks match reality and match the contract. Every overall project management task happens on this thing here. Now, because our sponsorships here at ProcessDriven are primarily kind of featured spots, meaning we have a regular video and then we throw an ad slot into it, we are not tracking the actual content creation here. Actually, how we do that is by using our regular content creation flow, which we talk about in this video, and just connecting it using a relationship in ClickUp to the sponsor. So when we're working on a given video, it says big up at the top, sponsored by, and it reminds me as the creator at the time of filming that video to include the plug. So we don't track the creation here. This is just all the project management stuff. I hope that makes sense. But again, if not, let me know in the comments. We'll dive deeper. One thing I actually haven't shown you in this layout yet is the relationship between these two lists. So if you are comfortable using ClickUp relationships, which we talk about in this video, here's what this looks like. We have a contracts relationship between the company info and the opportunities. We have it summing the amount of the contract, and we have that as a relationship. When it's actually created on a relevant task, we'll see it on both sides of the equation. And once here, we can actually connect the contract to the deal and it'll all sum up here. And this is how we go about organizing brand deals and sponsorships inside of ClickUp to keep things super organized with our process. The tools we're using in this are ClickUp and Missive. Information about both of those is in the description below. Both of them have great free plans where you could mock up pretty much exactly what I showed you here for free. And the whiteboarding tool I'm using today is Whimsical, but honestly, just grab a piece of paper and you can get the same benefit as what we have in Whimsical here. However, if you want to check this one out, we'll also have a link to that. If you have any questions about some of the things I've glossed over here today, or if you'd like me to dive deeper on any of these topics, please do let us know. And of course, if you found this helpful, if you'd like to see more process-driven videos like this, please do like and subscribe. It supports this channel, costs you nothing. And as this video has been unsponsored, it is like your payment for this free content. And I would really, really appreciate it. With that, thanks for watching and enjoy the process.